Hi, I'm Jim Grealis, the AU historian, and I'm in
Lancaster, Ohio.
Lancaster. I'm still working on getting that Lancaster right.
Hey, we'll get it right.
Okay.
We'll get it done.
Today is August 2nd, 2014, and I'm here with Terry Lynn. And we're here to talk about your experiences raising pigeons over the years. Terry, tell me about how you got started in raising pigeons.
Okay, I got started probably in 1960. I was 13 years old. Back then we used to get a magazine in the mail called Field & Stream magazine. And in the back of it, it would have animals for sale and stuff. My dad looked at it and said, homing pigeons. So he thought that'd be a good thing for me to get and try to raise. So we ordered them, and actually it was from Fort Dodge, Iowa, which was the home of Foy's Pigeon Supply back then. So they sent me two birds. Dad built a rabbit hutch. We kept them in there for 6 months, and they just kind of looked at each other, and we figured they were a pair. But I knew nothing about them to speak of and didn't know who to go talk to them about them. So Dad said, well, let's turn them loose and see if we'll stay here. Well, we all know what happened. He turned them loose, and 5 minutes later, they were gone. But I'm sure they probably didn't end up at where they were raised. I don't know. But never heard a word back from them. We did call them. So that's how I originally got started. Then later on, I ended up getting some roller pigeons off a guy. And I had rollers up till I was drafted to the military in 66. Spent 2 years in the Army, one in Nam and one stateside. Then I got out, came home, and I met my wife, Anna Mae Kimberly. And lo and behold, her dad and her brother raised homing pigeons. So I went in partnership with them for a couple of years, and then finally they decided to get rid of them. So they gave them all to me, and that's where I've been at ever since.
Now, how old were you when you first got your pigeons?
I was 13 years old when I first got the two.
And were you living right here in this town?
I was living in Carroll, outside of Carroll High, on Coon Path Road. That's where we lived at the time. So.
And how old were you when you got out of the military and you met your wife and got
Let's see, I went in the military, I think I was 19, I was about 21 years old.
All right, so there's about 8 years, give or take, 8-10 years before you got back into the pigeons again.
Well, I had the rollers, and when I went in the military, Dad pretty much just left them run free, and then when I came out of the military, I can remember coming home from the airport in Columbus, and we had this one barn up the ways from them. I kept looking up there, and there's a lot of black and white pigeons up there. Well, them rollers had intermingled with commies, and we had populated the area pretty good with roller pigeons. So I tried to catch some of them back, and I did, but I kind of lost interest. I had, back then, some pretty good rollers. They would hit the ground and roll all the way down to the ground. So.
Okay. What is your vocation today? I mean, what job do you work, or if you're retired?
I'm retired. I retired from the post office 36 years ago. Or no, I put 36 years in. I've been retired since the Ohio State Buckeyes won the national championship.
Okay.
You remember the Ohio State Buckeyes, don't you?
Oh yeah, Iowa plays them every year. So is Nebraska. Well, that's not true. Not anymore.
Yeah.
It's getting to be a little bit bigger conference.
Well, yeah, I'm a Buckeye fan. I like to talk about my Buckeyes.
I know that Buckeye fans like to do that.
It's a lot different. I mean, they're avid fans, more so, I think, than any other place. Yeah. Maybe not. Maybe just me.
How do you folks feel about the Michigan fans?
Oh, I would, if Ohio State can't win the national championship, I'd like to see Michigan win.
That was pretty well said.
And other than Michigan beat everybody, but not Ohio State.
Okay.